Today, I'm going to be answering the question, what firmware should I run on my FortiGate? Short answer, you should just run a mature release that's not hit end of engineering support. The longer answer is, as everything in IT, it depends. Before we go any further, if you haven't met me before, I'm Gregabyte and I talk all things network and security, and right now I'm really focused in on Fortinet solutions. Also, much of this is going to be my own opinions and not official guidance, although I will reference some official documentation, which is where I've gotten my opinions. So for that short answer, you can also just look at this great article that's kept up to date quarterly by Fortinet. It's just your recommended release for FortiOS. So if it's supported, it's going to suggest which version you should be running. It is updated quarterly, so it is sometimes a little bit out of date. As 7.2.8 is out right now, I imagine that that will be updated to include that. But this is updated back in April. So back to the long answer of it depends. So the first thing that I would always recommend doing is check the maturity tag on a version of FortiOS that you're looking at. If you're not familiar with the maturity tags, it's something that they released within FortiOS 7.2. If you look at a feature tag, that's going to include new features, also bug fixes, vulnerability patches. But the big thing is things are changing, which means that there is likely to cause more issues, more bugs that are getting fixed or implemented and might not be perfect the first time around. So effectively, a feature release means, yeah, it's stable enough. It's, you know, general availability, but it is higher risk to have issues. On the flip side, we've got the mature tag, which is what I'm saying that you should really be looking for inside of a FortiOS release. That's saying that we're done doing new features, no new major features, and this is mostly just going to be bug fixes and vulnerability patching. This is going to result in a much more stable release, and it's going to impact your business less. Now, this is something that you can see within the GUI as you're updating things. Another place that you can go to see this is the upgrade path tool table. Now, if we go look at the current FortiOS version and we drop it down, we'll scroll down to the bottom here. We can see that 7.0 hit mature at 7.0.9 and 7.2 hit mature at 7.2.7. So F is for feature, M is for mature, and anything on 7.4 is currently on feature release. I also wanted to take a little bit of time to talk about the firmware lifecycle on FortiOS. So this is a document that you can get on the support site that breaks down a lot more than just the firmware lifecycle, but I wanted to focus in on this little chart here. So for 3 years or 36 months after it's released, we're going to have full support, and then we're going to hit end of engineering support. So that's when we're only going to be really getting patches for critical alerts or critical vulnerabilities in the industry or pcerts. And so that's going to happen for the next year and a half or 18 months. To see that broken down a bit easier on the exact version of FortiOS that you might be looking for, you can go to your support account, hit support, and then product lifecycle. It'll bring you to this page. And this link here is actually going to get you that document that I was just showing you. So if we scroll down to FortiOS, then we can start seeing all the different versions. So we see that 7.0 released in 2021, 7.2 in 2022, and 7.4 in 2023. So we can see they're releasing one about every year. We've got that 3-year life cycle and then a year and a half from end of engineering support to full end of support. So I wanted to break that down a little bit more visually. That's just how my brain works. So I want to help break that down for other people. So if we look here, we see 7.0 was released in 2021. And then before it hit mature, we actually already had 7.2 released in early 2022. Late 2022, we got to a mature release of 7.0. And then we hit a mature release of 7.2 in early 2024, which is right around the exact same time that we went end of engineering support on 7.0. And both of those took about a year and 9 months apart to reach full maturity. So looking at that and just applying the same math, this is 100% just an estimation, but if the same timeline applies with the release in mid-2023, we should see early 2025 7.4 reach a mature state. So when I said it depends, that's because sometimes there are features within the new versions of FortiOS that have not reached mature state yet that may be a business requirement and a reason that you move to Fortinet or something that is going to be huge quality of life increase. And you may want to move there before it's hit mature. And that is perfectly fine. Understanding that risk and looking at the release notes, I would just highly recommend every single release really vetting the entire release note, checking for any known issues, fixed issues, new features that are getting implemented, and really do your homework on there. You don't have to do that as much with a mature release because things aren't changing as much. So what about 7.6? It was just released at Accelerate. I have a lot of people saying, hey, should I be, you know, skipping right to 7.6 the second that it drops? And I would say no. For most people, you don't want to jump on a .0, .1, or .2 release of new FortiOS. Again, that level of more bugs getting fixed, new features getting implemented means more issues for you. If that's going to be a make it or break it on the feature availability, then this again comes down to a risk decision. So while the new features may be amazing and have really great quality of life improvement and help your business a lot, it also might result in more troubleshooting, administrative overhead that you need to do to keep this thing up and running and keep your business operational. So again, for about 99% of the people who I talk to, a mature release that has not hit end of engineering support is going to be my recommendation every time. In the best case, you'd probably be testing out 7.4 right now in a lab environment. This is going to allow you to get used to the new features, get used to the new GUI look, as things slowly get updated so that it's not a new change in the middle of production. It's something you've already tested out inside of a lab or dev environment. Again, these are just my opinions. The documents are all going to be listed down below, so do your own research and this will change throughout time. Hope this was helpful and we'll talk to you soon.